Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to take you in a plant tour in my house. All these plants which I am going to show you is easy to care and don't give you much stress about their maintenance. Most of all these plants are recommended by NASA. NASA did an air clean study in 1989 to find out the most effective common easy to care indoor plants for filtering the toxins and pollutants from the air you breathe. As you can see, this is my philodendron lime lemon. I water this plant when the soil feels dry and put it on my window where it can get bright but indirect sunlight. Do you want to know what is in your air we breathe? The air present in our indoors as well as in our outdoors contains harmful chemicals like trichloroethylene, formaldehyde, benzene, xylene and ammonia. As you can see, this plant is known as Chinese evergreen or aglaonema. This plant is easy to care and low maintenance. This plant can goes well in both indoors as well as in outdoors. Water it when the soil feels dry. Harmful chemical trichloroethylene is present in printing inks, paints, paint removers. The symptoms with short-term exposure of this harmful chemical includes excitement, dizziness, headache, nausea and vomiting. As you can see, this plant is called Syngonium goosefoot. This plant is easy to care and excellent low-light plant. Plant seems to remove benzene, formaldehyde, toluene and xylene. A to Z information about Syngonium is present in my Syngonium video. The link is given below in the description box. As you can see, this is my another Chinese evergreen. This plant is known as Aglaonema maria. Easy to care plant and need very bright sunlight. Don't put them in direct light. Water them when the soil feels dry. Harmful chemical benzene, which can be removed by all these house plants, can be found in plastics, resins, synthetic fibers, detergents, dyes, drugs, pesticides, and can also be found in tobacco smoke, vehicle exhaust and furniture wax. Short-term exposure of this chemical, it can cause irritation to eyes, drowsiness, increase in heart rate and headache. All know this plant is known as spider plant. The plant can remove formaldehyde and xylene. The total information about this plant is present in my spider plant video. The link is present in the description box. Harmful chemical formaldehyde, which is present in paper bags, waxed paper, paper towels, synthetic fibers, can cause skin irritation, irritation to nose, mouth, throat, and in severe case can cause swelling of larynx and lungs. Now you are looking at my peace lilies. This plant seems to remove benzene, formaldehyde, trichloroethylene, xylene and ammonia. Plant is easy to care and can work very well in low light conditions. Another harmful chemical, xylene, which is present in printing, rubbers, leather paint industries, tobacco smoke and vehicle exhaust, can cause in a short term exposure irritation to mouth and throat, dizziness, heart problem and in severe cases can lead to liver and kidney damage. As you can see, this is my another philodendron. This philodendron names philodendron imperial red.
As you can see, this is my jade pothos. They love moisture and indirect sunlight.
Also can remove harmful chemical benzene and makes your air free of other chemicals. Let's talk about another harmful chemical, ammonia, which can be found in window cleaners, floor waxes, smelling sandals and fertilizers. With a short-term exposure of this chemical, it can cause eye irritation, cough and sore throat.
You can see, this plant is known as Diffenbachia or dumpkin.
goes well in indoors as well as in outdoors. Several of these plants are known to be toxic to cats, dogs and other pets. So, before adding to your home, please check the toxicity. As you can see, this is my Chinese fan palm, easy to care and maintain. Now you are looking at my Dracaena. This is easy to care plant and goes well with a little watering and bright sunlight. Its colorful foliage makes it a beautiful indoor plant. Now let's see my another house plant. As you can see, this is my aloe vera plant. Let's move to my another house plant. As you can see, this is Philodendron Xanadu, easy to care plant and another baby of my philodendron collection. You are looking at my another variety of Dracaena. I exactly don't know the name, but I care this plant as my other Dracaenas. As you can see, this is my Song of India. Very easy to propagate in soil and water. Need very low maintenance and very helpful to reduce harmful chemicals from your indoors. This is my another variety of palm. This plant is known as casket palm. As you can see, this is my lucky bamboo plant. I placed this plant in water, but after several months, the stems starting getting yellow. That's why I removed this plant from water and placed them in soil. As you can see, this is my Syngonium. The total A to Z care about Syngonium is given in the description box. Please check out the video. As you can see, this is my snake plants. The A to Z information about snake plants is given in the description box. As you can see, this is my Boston fern. Not very easy to care because they need a lot of humidity. But they seem to remove harmful chemicals too. As you can see, this is my another variety of fern. This fern is known as foxtail fern. This plant also loves humidity. As you can see, this is my Syngonium. I grow this plant totally in water. I changed the plant water after 3 to 4 days. As you can see, this is my Caladium plant. I placed this plant in indirect sunlight and water when the soil is dry. You can see this is one of my croton. Very easy to care and I place this plant in direct sunlight. This is my another variety of croton. These in green and yellow shades. Very easy to care plant.
Again, my another croton for you. Mostly all of these croton are grown by me through stem cutting. You're looking at one of my variegated aerially. Very easy to care plant. I place this plant in indirect sunlight. I exactly don't know the name of this plant, but I think this plant is agave. As you can see, this is my Oxalis purple. I grow this plant by their bulb. This is my wandering Jew cutting. I place this plant in indirect sunlight. Very easy to care plant. As you can see, this is my basil plant. I water this plant daily and place them in direct sunlight. As you can see, these are my golden pothos. I propagate this plant totally in water. I replace this plant water after 3 to 4 days. Right guys, thank you so much for watching my houseplant tour, and it's really fun to introduce you to my plant babies. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And please don't forget to turn on the notification button, because I do share a lot of important stuff regarding houseplant. Love you guys. Bye.